And Professor Bologna et al. Will speak about.
So it called the generalized adjoint.
Generalized adjoint action.
Right. Okay, so I will talk about generalized joint actions. And so this is just the joint paper with a kind of Berenstein.
Should it be adjoint within?
So?
Should it be adjoint within? Sorry, that's
okay,
not...
Okay, all right. All right.
Berenstein is in... But basically, first of all, this is a byproduct of our teaching. And so when you are teaching Lie groups, the course of Lie groups, and Lie algebras, you can see to solve the following problem, basically. Suppose you have x, y are just noncommuting variables. And people want to express, you have just then this joint action, so this is just exponent of x, how is this, and you want to present this as series, and usually so what you do, you are writing this as y, then you have commutator x, y, over 1 factorial, then you have a double commutator over 2 factorial, and so on. So usually people write this as add x to the k of y over k factorial, and so on. And here, that's a standard notation. Y, so add to the k means that you consider iteration of this. Well, it's actually not rigorous because when you are writing this infinite sum, you have to explain how to understand this infinite sum. So you need some topology, what people usually do here. So x, y, matrices, you can turn some topology. Maybe the easiest thing is just to consider this action, say y x, so tau is just a central formal variable, and then you are writing this, let me write this in the form of the sum at x to the k, y to the k factorial, and then tau to the k. The k, and then you understand this just as formal series. All right, now people who are doing sort of a quantum case, they know that there is a generalization of this for our so-called quantum exponents. And there are several definitions of quantum exponents, and they're different. I will use the most primitive one. The most primitive one that I will take, I will have this m cubed as y plus q plus so plus q to the m minus 1. I can write this this way. And then this is just a sum of x to the n over n q factorial, and factorial is just a
a standard factorial. This is just a product of all those guys.
Okay, and now then how you generalize this. So first of all, let me introduce the generalized bracket. So I will use x, y, u, and means x, y minus q, y, x. Well, q is just a scalar.
The factorial, is that?
Yeah, that's right, standard factorial. Thing? That's a standard factorial. So just m, q factorial means that this is 1, q times 2q.
Q.
As I said, that's the most primitive generalization of the exponents. So let's do this. And then there is a formula that can be written in this way. Again, I'm abusing, you know, this is well, some holes here, and this is y plus x, y, q, 1, q factorial, plus, here you have just x, y, then the next you have x, y, and then you put here q. Let me write that I have x, y. I will just write this as x, y. So this is just 1 and q, and this is 2 q factorial. Then the next term will be x, y. So the next term will be q, and the next term will be q square, and this will be over 3 q factorial, and so on. So let me just maybe explain. All right, this better. So I will.
Who did it first?
This was known by Fadeev's school when they were doing this one. To be honest, I never were able to find exactly this formula, but so it was.
Yeah, it's implicit.
Yes, but it seems that this. So it's around 1990, so it was known. So let me maybe introduce them. Such notation, 1, q, q square, q of x applied to y, and it means that I'm, of course, taking x, y, or as 1, 1, then the next will be q, then the next will be q square, and so on, and the last one will be q minus 1. And therefore, you can write this as follows: x q. Okay, and this is y, say, plus 1 sum. And then the question that we asked ourselves, what is if we replace those exponents just by any formal series? So you consider just the formal series of x1 plus a1x plus a2x squared plus so on. And you want actually to generalize generalize those formulas for this case. And so surprisingly, nobody asked some of this question before. So I'm going to write you an answer to this. And again, I need just slightly to generalize this. So if I will write at, and then here I will write.
Like you're doing the Q case. In the original?
Sorry?
In the original case, it has been done? You're talking about the Q case, right?
No, this is. It was not by the Q case. So here, just any formal series.
But the commutator is the Q commutator?
The commutator is generalization of Q commutator, so let me just explain.
But for the usual commutator, it had been done before? For the usual commutator, when Q equals 1?
This one? No, this
no,
one.
No, this case, for the general, for the usual commutator, has been known before?
This case?
Yeah.
No, nobody
was interested. Not even for the usual commutator?
No. Yeah. Nobody was, as far as I know, nobody. Yeah. Okay. Let me maybe, so I will just introduce the following. So suppose I will write just any constants here, Q1, Q2, and Qk, and x applied to y. And this means that I'm just applying force with this parameter, then I'm applying x with this parameter, and so on, and finally I'm applying x with this parameter. So I will use just this notation. Now, before doing this, I have to introduce a class of polynomials. And just let me introduce the generating function for a class of polynomials k of t, and k will be say less equal to 1, maybe, and it's given by the following. Is the generating function, and okay, I will add notation f here, f k sub k, and I will introduce polynomials with these formulas k of t, f of k, and k greater or equal than 1. Okay, so this is just generating functions for this polynomial. You can actually easily, get a formula from this. I believe it was known to Vronsky or whatever this. And basically then you can write the formula f of t, and it's given by determinant. And the determinant is this, a1t. A2t squared, ak t to the k, a1, a2 to the k, 0, 1, 1, a1, so this is a1, ak minus 1. Okay, so over here, 0. So this is almost triangular matrix. And P is given by this. Okay, now I will discuss properties of this polynomial later, but let me just write you the final answer here. And now then you have a theorem, which is
written by this f of x by f x minus 1 equals y plus some k greater or equal than 1 and this is q, where is q by k, q to k, q k k, x applied to y, sorry, and must be, so it must be coefficient here, a k, sub k. So the coefficient from this function, and where q1 k, q1 q2k, so on qk are roots of pfk of t. So that's the general answer.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
If these were not non-commuting, if they were ordinary commuting variables, you could invert f of x, the Taylor series, f of x formally, and just expand it.
Yes.
And this will collapse to that, presumably, when you put the x and y is commute.
If x and y is commute, you have here just y, and you have a standard. So if they commute, then this is zero. So you just have y.
So yes, then you prove that f times y times y.
Okay, now then, I will investigate this, but to convince you that this is basically generalization, I have to compute those polynomials in known cases.
So did you get back the classical formula?
Yes, exactly. I will get now the classical formula.
But we don't divide by factorial?
This is case. So you have the factorial already this factorial.
But what is a sub k? Can you tell them explicitly?
No, but this is, they came from this.
Oh, it came out.
F of x
so one.
Is 1 plus a1 of x plus a2 squared. So, okay, and then again, let me assume that those are all non-zero for simplicity.
Yeah.
So this is your series. Then I construct those polynomials using this formula. And then I'm using, you know, their roots to express this. Now,
do all the roots need to be positive?
Sorry?
Do all the roots need to be positive?
Not necessarily. That's up to them.
But somehow we will get the denominator k factorial as n in a special case.
Let me write you the answer. Let me write you just a proposition.
Yeah, of course. It makes sense.
That if f of x equals p to the x, this implies that p f of k of t is just a product 1 minus t or t minus 1. Oh, let me check this. Oh, sorry. It's t minus 1 k over k. T minus 1 to the k. Now, if f of x is this quadratic thing,
this implies that P of K of T is just T minus 1, T minus Q, T minus Q to the K minus 1. And you get this thing. Okay, now, so my question is actually this is, well, actually to describe those polynomials for, let's say, famous series f of x. For example, let's take a hypergeometric function. Confluent hypergeometric functions
what's the question?
The question is how to describe. You see that in this case they have a nice description. In general, I can write you only this formula. So basically the thing is if this determinant has a nice factorization for other f of x. This I don't know. Okay. Now, the only thing that I know is that say for f of x equals e to the x, or more generally q, then you have the p fk of t divides p fk plus 1 of t. And this follows just from this formula. So therefore, those parameters, they're sort of increasing, and so you have sort of a stabilization. Now, but in general, it's not true. In fact, that is just a remark due to one of our graduate students, Alejandro. So he noticed that if the f of k of t divides p f k plus 1 of t, then actually f is written as ax q. F of x is just this. So this is basically. No, it's rather rare. But again, maybe it's interesting to just, you know. Okay, I just want to say just one word about an interesting lemma which was used to prove this theorem, and then I will discuss some properties of this polynomial sphere for this. Actually, the lemma, which is actually very simple and known to experts, but not to all experts, so to speak, and this is if you take x and and apply this to y. I was writing probably, and this is in a different way. But this is actually sum g0 k minus 1 g e j 1 q 2 q k x k minus g y x g. And where those are elementary symmetric functions. So for example, E1 of Q1 to K just the sum. Because you know that the roots of the polynomials are also elementary symmetric functions. So this is just also an exercise in algebra. Okay, and now I would like to talk about... So this is, okay, as I say, this is just a note, so that this is actually so the matrix how. That you can write this in this form. But you can say some properties, you can say something about properties of these polynomials. And let me just maybe. So this is not orthogonal polynomials, as you see, because the recurrence is a long recurrence. And another property is that how they behave with the product. And this is just...
In the first formula, is there an F missing in number one?
Yes, yes. I have always right. And so that's just another formula. And and now let me just maybe, again, I don't know that much about properties of this. Now let me just show maybe how to apply this to get famous formulas. All right, I will probably. Okay, now it's known that